So let's see now another example. Actually, this is the location example. If you remember last time, when we see this example and we say we will back to this example in the queries, since we want to verify the time on some locations. In this example, we have three type of locations, normal one, and the normal one, urgent and committed. So we want to check the time on in this, for example, in urgent locations, because we say urgent location, the time is freezing. So we just want to see, is it freezing? That means is the location, the time here is yellow zero. So how we can write this here is just here. This is the simulation of our of this example. So let's see, for example, if we have okay, for example, here we have B is the process and B0 is the process. So we want to ask about the value of X. So X here, X is the clock. Is the clock in location in the process zero in the location is the value of X greater than zero? So we can see, let's see. So we go and open save. We open the location example here. Here is the location. No, it's not this. Location example. We have, as we say, it's three types of location. So we the here is the simulators, and we can check the behaviors of the system. If we want to go to the verify, okay, we have money, but okay, we want to insert one new one. Okay, we want to see the value of, so I will say is the process zero and the location is one. Process zero, location is one. Process zero, location is one. So this one is the value is greater than zero. It's L greater than zero. So here, that's mean this one. It's not mean it's always, it's sometimes in some state. So let's see, it's true. Actually here, so this query is true. Actually, why is true? Because actually we use in existing, in some existing value. So here, so in this example of reachability, we want to see the value of X, or is the value of X is greater than zero in this in location, in the location S, which is in process B0. Is it true or false? So the second one, this is related to, we want actually to check the second one, the second the urgent. We want to see the urgent value. So the urgent value, that's mean here one in P in all the time, actually we should to say in all times B0 it's greater than zero. So B1 here, yeah, in B1 for example, because B1 is, this is B1, and you want to ask about the value here, about the time in S1. So the time in S1, B1 and S1. Oh. S will be capital. So is not satisfied, is not greater than zero. It's not greater than zero because this type of location, it's urgent. And we say that does mean that the time is zero. I mean, now if I think, so is it greater than zero? No. So is it equal to zero? So let's check. also still no, not equal to 0. So, oh, so still also not same. So why? What the problem? Why not equal to 0? Okay, one thing here. Actually, here we say in all times, in all the state, we are in B1, in the location S1, and the value, it's actually here, I know that I just bring you to this point. I want to bring you to this point. Why not Z? Why not true? Why not true? Okay. Actually, I know why not true or not satisfied. Here, what's mean? What's mean this query? We say here in all state, B will be in, B1 will be in S1, and B1 equal to 0. You see here, and that means this is should be satisfied all the time. That means all the time the system will be in B1, S1. All the time will be, all the time we should be here. We should not move from this place. So, and this is not true. So, why we, what we should to do? We want to ask about this. About this location. So, we want to ask only about this location. So, we should to change this query. So, here should be imply. Imply, that's mean. If you are in B1, in the process B1, and you are in S1, so this is imply that the value of x in this B will be 0. Is it true or no? So now we check. So it's true. So this is how to check now if you're in a specific location. So now, as we say, if we say and, that means we should satisfy these and this, but we want to satisfy, or we want to check this value, which is x, in the location S1 of the process B1. Okay, so this is, maybe we should say what the difference between imply and. So we give one table to show you what the difference between that, between these two keyword. So here, as we say, is and I will add this one, the new one, that's to check the time on specific location. So here, another also more example, as we say here, with the difference between imply and state. So what's mean and what's mean? So here is more example on the location and how with the result. So here is, as I told you, we should to see what the difference between them. So actually the difference between and imply. In and, actually we say that and should satisfy the two conditions. For example, if we have the first condition, it's, for example, S1 and X1. So both of them should be true. That means I should be in the location S1, and at the same time I should be true. So, but if we use imply, this is for and should be true both of them. But and actually imply, that means if the first one is correct, so we see the second one. If you are in London, so you are in UK. This is the difference between imply and. So in imply, actually you see all, most of them is we have three true, only false if the first one is true, and then the false will be false. Why here? Only true if both of them is true. So you can see, that means once we see if you are in S1, and here we write what's mean, what we write, that's in all times. So in all times you are in S1. This is so, it's correct, it's wrong. So this condition will not satisfy. So that means this, if we write and, so it's all the time will be false because this one is not satisfied. So of course the result of the whole query will be also incorrect. So this is incorrect, so the one is incorrect. Not satisfied, that means not satisfied. But this, the first one, if the first one is correct, satisfied, then you check the second one. So this is the difference between imply and.